There's nothing that needs to be said. We can pretend we'll sandblast these walls and paint them again. When everything comes to an end, we can pretend we'll sandblast these walls and paint them again.
Hey guys, Red Panda Mining here. Welcome back to another video. Hope you're all having an awesome day and are getting ready for the new year. Smash that like button if you enjoyed that intro. Today, we look at the EVGA GeForce GTX 970 4GB Superclock Edition as I attempt to see if this card can still mine the hottest proof of work coins on Earth right now. I'll be test mining on a custom mining frame I made out of aluminum and wood, coupled with this Thermaltake 850W RGB Gold rated PSU, a BioStar TB250 BTC mining motherboard, 4GB of DDR4 RAM, an Intel G3930 CPU, the latest U-Bit PCIe risers. Guys, I'll be explaining and using a bunch of mining software and Windows 10, showcasing the hash rates and electrical wattage that we can attain with this card. This will be a long video. I'll timestamp everything in the comments. Let's get started, guys. Alright guys, so as you can see in your top right, I got a video, just a little webcam on the rig, my single rig with the GTX 970 on it right now. And below that, I got another webcam pointing to the kilowatt. I got a base wattage right now of 30.5 watts. I know it's showing around 34, 35 right now, but that's because we got Chrome tabs open. Chrome tabs take a bit of wattage. Let's see if I close it. Here, I'm just gonna make sure I continue where I left off. Close that. Close these tabs. Let it idle for a bit. That you'll see the wattage go down to 30, 31. So that's pretty that's pretty interesting that Chrome tabs take wattage. Okay, well let's open this back up. So as you can see, I got what to mine here. I'm gonna be putting all the hash rates in. Most of them, I'll do as many as I can, and we'll see how much this GTX 970 can mine. As for reference, I've already done the Ethereum Ethereum hash rate. This is probably the most common one to do on the GTX 970 right now. One of the main things is that you gotta have compute performance enabled, and I got that tip from Mr. Crypto Z on the aeonpool.tech. He's one of the pool operators, really cool guy, same with Yashnik. When you open up the NVIDIA control panel, you'll see that you'll need to enable optimize for compute performance. Make sure you have that on. Another thing is I have DSR factors just at 120x, 1.2x. And you can start mining Ethereum and all that stuff. And other coins. So let's close that. So I'm going to begin with let's start with mining Aeon coin. So let's get my afterburner settings here so you guys can see what I'm going to be running overclock settings on. So yeah, we're going to like underclock the power limit to 85%. The core clock will be 100 plus 120. Memory clock will be plus 350. And I just have the fan speed at 50 right now. Really depends how hot your place is. It's winter time right now, so you don't really need to run the fans too high. I usually have it around 60 or 70, like in the summertime. Okay, so the miners that we're going to be using are G minor and EWBF. We're gonna test both of these on Aeon. I got the links here. I'll have them in the description. But yeah, you can download these on bitcointalk.org. The G minor CUDA Equihash miner 1.13. So this miner specifically can mine different Equihash algorithms. It supports Minex coin, Bitcoin Gold, Bitcoin Z, Snow Gem, Safecoin, Litecoin Z, Zero, Genesis, and Aeon. So we're gonna try Aeon here with the G miner. So let's edit the config here. We're gonna mine directly to this awesome pool here. Aeonpool.tech. I'm not sponsored by them, guys. I just really like these guys. I really like the server. I have most of my rigs right now on Aeon. So let's check this out. So let's add in the information here. So you want to go to Aeonpool.tech, go to connect, type in the stratum. We can just do the cluster one. It automatically selects the closest stratum to you. Go to your batch file server, plop it in here, port, we're going to be doing small miner, so it's port 2222, port 2222, user, we're just going to, okay, is this the pool's wallet address right now? What is this balance? You know what? We're gonna mine to this. We're gonna mine to this wallet just because we're just testing right now. So, boom. All right. Yeah. Make sure you got the 210_9 algo and PERS is Aeon, all capitals, zero capital P, lowercase O, capital W. So this matters. You have to make sure it is case sensitive. So, all right. So once you got that all in there, you have to save. Go back to your Gminer here, and let's see what hash rate we can get and wattage. Ah, Aeon. All right, Aeon. Gminer Equihash miner 1.13. Oh, got the first accepted share. That's good. As you guys can see, the wattage is around 170 at the moment. So minus 30 would be around 140. 140 watts usage around there. Minus the Chrome tab, so 135. Okay, so it's reporting 145 here. We're getting 140 souls. Mining Aeon right now, guys. This is pretty good. Pretty good. So I'm gonna put in here on what to mine. We're gonna do 140. I'm not gonna calculate the cost that we're gonna get per, because if you're mining with a GTX 970 right now, you might be losing. I'm probably on par right now because my wattage is 0.06 cost per kilowatt per hour. So it depends on what your guys' kilowatt per hour right now, but for the sake of the video, I'm just going to show just the wattage and hash rate. Just the hash rates. But I'll show you guys the wattage per the coin that we mine, depending on the software we use. Okay, guys. Yeah. So yeah, looks like it's going there. 140 souls. We're at 170 watts total system. So that's not too bad. 0.1 soul per watt. Not too bad. All right, guys. We're gonna go to the next software that I like. It's EWBF. This is going to the Aeon coin as well. Let's just quickly, I just want to see what... Oh, we forgot to edit the batch file. Let's edit that first. Let's put the Aeon pool in here. Aeonpool.tech, cluster.aeonpool.tech. Copy it in there. It's port 222 because we're just doing one right now. One video card. And plop in the wallet address, your own wallet address. And all you gotta do 210_9, and this is gonna be the Aeon POW. There we go. All right, save. Let's run the EWF miner, see what kind of hashes we get. So we were getting 140. No properly configured pool. Okay, I did something wrong. Miner, I'll go to... Oh. I typed in something wrong, it looks like. 210_9. There we go. Cluster.ampool.tech port 2222. Alright, let's go. There we go. Alright, so let's see, let's compare wattage and compare the hash rate to the Gminer. Found an accepted share already. Interesting. Ooh, 129 souls on the EWBF. So it looks like the Gminer, you get an extra 10 souls on that one. And the wattage, it seems 170 is about the same. So yeah, it looks like the Gminer is a better software than the EWBF. 129 souls. Yep, so we were getting 140 on the Gminer. Alright, so yeah, I'd recommend using the Gminer instead of the EWBF. That's cool, guys. Well, that's just for the GTX 970 anyway. Alright, guys, on to the next one. Let's try Ravencoin next. We're gonna use the T-Rex Miner. And you guys can download this on Bitcoin Talk. I'll have the link down in the description. So yeah, I'm gonna use the same core clock settings here for Ravencoin that we did for Aeon. So let's go. Let's just see what we got here. I'm just mining to a random test pool. You guys can find if you go to Ravencoin pools. There's a website here. Is it this one? No, there's a really cool Ravencoin pool website. Yeah, okay. Miningpoolstats.stream. So as you can see here, the supernova.cc has one of the most highest miners right now, but the pool fee is zero, so that's why everyone's on it. So I would you know, stay decentralized and mine on these other pools out here. Technically, I would I'd recommend going to the technicalspool.com. It's, if you guys watch the technicals, he's a cool guy. He's got his own pool here, and he mines a whole bunch of different coins here. Really speculative coin mining. Really, I really like it. Yeah, you should check him out. Check him out, guys. The technical pool, technicalspool.com, and check out his YouTube as well. He's really cool. Really smart. Yeah. Okay. So let's see what the hash rates we're getting right now, and the wattage. So the wattage seems to be about the same: 167, 170, 165. And we're going to about 13 mega hash. That's pretty good. Pretty good. So that's the 16R algorithm. So 13, put that there. Okay. Looks pretty good, guys. So yeah, 170 watts, 160, it's jumping around. I know that the Raven coin will be jumping around there, so jumping around in hash rates because it's mining like 12 or 16 different algorithms in one algorithm. Not sure I explained that right, but yeah, the hash rates will fluctuate from like, you know, 8 mega hash to maybe 16 mega hash or 13 mega hash, 10 mega hash. Yeah, it depends on which algorithm it's mining at the time. Okay, guys, that's Ravencoin. Let's go. Let me close that. And let me close everything here. Let's now open up. Let's open up NiceHash. So maybe most of you mining do like NiceHash if you like mining into Bitcoin. Yeah, I know a lot of people are doing that. I personally don't do that. I mine the coins directly. But just for the sake of the video, I'm just gonna show what the hash rates that we can get with this card through NiceHash. So I know a lot of people will be using NiceHash. So if you go open it up here, go to hardware details, click on the card itself. I got all the algorithms disabled. So as you can see, you know, like the most profitable one that shows in NiceHash right now is the X16R, you know. But actually, if you go to the Nice profitability calculator, I think it's gonna say Ethereum is the most profitable right now. Yeah, so with the GTX 970, apparently on NiceHash, you can get 0.29 USD a day. And the most profitable coin to mine with this card right now is Dagger Hashimoto, which is Ethereum. Yeah, pretty interesting. But the point of the video, we're going to be finding out the hash rates that we can get. So let's go, let's try Kryptonite right now. Let's do Kryptonite V8, see what kind of hash rate we can get with this. Normally I'd be using like XMR stack or something like that, but just for faster hash rates and just to see what it, faster hash rate speed, just to see what we can get right now. So looks Kryptonite V8, looks like it's fluctuating everywhere, 300, 290, 433, 290. Oh, the wattage, guys, look at the wattage, 115, 110, 107, 114. Wow, that's way lower than 170 from Aeon and Ravencoin. I'm gonna let this go for a little bit more. See, making like 8-10 cents a day on Kryptonite V8. Okay, so we've safely arrived at around 265, 270 hash for Kryptonite. So let's go, let's type in 260 here. 266, I'm just gonna say 270. 270 hash for Kryptonite V8. Okay, guys, let's go find another. Let's do another coin here. Let's do NeoScript. So let's disable this. Let's go to NeoScript here. Start. See what kind of hash rates we can get on this 970. Whoa! As you can see, the wattage jumped up 171 watts on NeoScript. 556, 552. Gonna let this go for a bit to even out. 554. Yeah, so 555. Okay, so it looks like the average is around 555, 552. I'm gonna do 555 NeoScript. 555 at 170 watts. Whew, quite a bit. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna write type all these down. So Ethereum 22 mega hash, and then 170 watts. Aeon for G miner, it's gonna be 140 sols, 170 watts. Yeah, I'm not gonna add the EWF one because G miner is better. Then what else? What did we test after that? We tested Ravencoin T-Rex. It's about 13 mega hash with the same thing, 170 watts. And now we're doing Nice Hash Crypto Knight V8. It was we're getting 270 hash with 110 watts only. Now we're doing Nice Hash NeoScript 555 kilohash at 170 watts as well. Okay guys, we're gonna try the next coin. What do you guys wanna try here? Let's see, NeoScript, what else does, oh, Lyra 2Z. Lyra 2Z, let's try that on Nice Hash. One point nine mega hash, 1.92 mega hash, 7 cents a day, 1.91. Okay, so it's around 1.9. Nice Hash, Lyra 2Z, 1.91 mega hash. How much wattage is that? 165, 170. So yeah, 170 as well. So 1.9 on Lyra 2Z. 1.91. Okay, that's Nice Hash. That's Lyra 2Z. All right, let's go to the next one, guys. And Kekak. Is Kekak on here? No. Probably not profitable. Pascal, no. Kryptonite V7, no. Oh, that's it. Okay, guys. Well, those are all the hash rates we can get for this 970, or that's compared to what to mine for the most profitable. So if we hit calculate, okay, so according to all this and the hash rates, it looks like Ravencoin, Ethereum are on the top as most profitable for this coin. For this video card, for this GTX 970. I'd say, yeah, 32 cents for Ethereum, 33 cents for Ravencoin. Oh, pretty good. 27 Ravencoin a day. 0.002 Ethereum a day. Where's Aeon? Aeon's not too far behind, so it's about 4 cents behind, but that it really fluctuates. I mean, if you guys are speculating and you guys think that Aeon can go much higher, which I think it could, then look at that. With one GTX 970, you can buy 1.8 Aeon a day. You get a whole coin and then some. So 0.028 cents a day on Aeon. Pretty close. They're all pretty close. So I would just mine the coin that you guys and they all get similar similar wattage. To be honest, guys, I wouldn't be using NiceHash for anything to mine. Like, if you guys want to auto change to Bitcoin, I mean, I know some people are lazy but don't have time. That makes sense. But maybe go use Mining Pool Hub. I think they have a better multi-algorithm miner that puts everything to Bitcoin. But in the meantime, yeah, with your GTX 970, you can. The top three right now I would be mining with would be Ethereum, Aeon, or Ravencoin with this card. So, yeah. Check it out, guys. I'm just going to put my wattage in here, see what cost per kilowatt. See if I'm still. Oh, I didn't put the. Oh, yeah. 170. So if it's 170, but minus 30 watts base wattage would be 140. So 140, and X16R is 140. So let's calculate 0.06 cents. Boom! After my electrical cost, I'm still making 11 cents. 8 cents a day, 13 cents a day on this GTX 970. The GTX 970 is still profitable for me, guys. Still profitable for me in this day and age. In pretty much end of 2018, that's now going to be 2019 in the next 2 days, guys. That's pretty funny. Alright, guys. This is a really long video. I'll have it all timestamped. I'm sure whoever stayed this long and watched the whole video, I commend you. Please say down in the comments if you watched the whole video. Oh man, I can't believe it. But yeah, have a good one, guys. I'll see you guys in the next video. Hope you all have a good new year coming up. I'll probably make another video talking about what's new for 2019, what's my plan, what coins you guys should be mining, what's my opinion on everything. I'll see you guys in the next one. Please like and subscribe. Have a good one.